So guys, welcome back on to another channel where today I'll be discussing on other few graph terminologies, that is degrees, weighted graph, adjacency, which I have not discussed in the previous session. These are few other terminologies which I will be continuing in the session. So let us see the formal definition of a graph theory. So graph theory, a graph G is equal to V comma A, that is V is vertex and A is edge, consists of two sets. So the finite non-empty set of vertices V, as you can see in the diagram, this is called a vertex, and the lines which connect one vertex to three, that is your edge. Okay. So the definition is the finite set E of unordered pairs of distinct vertices is called an edge. This is the formal definition of a graph terminology that I'll be discussing. For a non-empty set, it is of vertices V, and for finite set of unordered distinct vertices, it is called as edges. So V of G and E of G represent the set of vertices and edges of respectively. So this is how you represent a vertex, that is V of G of a graph and E of G of a graph for edges. So the definition of vertex is, in the graph theory, a vertex, that's a plural vertices, correct? That means it's not like you can have one vertices, it's like you can have infinite number of vertices. It can either be one or infinite. So a vertex, plural vertices, or a node or a point, you can call this a node or a point, but in graph we usually call this node as a vertex, is a fundamental unit out of which graphs are formed. Okay. Edges or arcs or links, so the lines which represent, which connect your both vertex, is your edge. It is also called edge, arcs or links, or even lines, gives a relationship between two vertices. So this is a formal definition which is regarding your graph theory. Next, here are a few examples of how to represent your graph theory. Like this is the graph, G1 is in graph, G2 is a tree graph, and G3 is also a graph. So how do you represent your vertices and your edges? So let's take vertex G1. So when you see the vertices, I said vertices are nothing but the nodes which are connected. So therefore your vertices are nothing but this is your vertex. 0 is your vertex, 2 is also vertex, 3 is also a vertex, 1 is also, we represent it in the form of set, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So how do you represent E of G1, that is edge? So edge is nothing but the lines which connect between the vertices. So if you take 0 to 2, you have a line. Am I correct? 0, 2. So you define all the vertices in edge, that is, since there is no declaration. Suppose if there is a value called E1 or there's a value called 10 over here, then you would write in the form of set as E1, 10 and so on. But since there is no definition or there is no declaration of any graph, you simply take it as 0 to 1, or 1 to 0, both are the same, and 0 to 2, 3 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 2 and 0 to 3. You take all the possible cases, that is your edge. Similarly, even in the case of graph G2. So your vertices are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 as mentioned. And E2 is all your connective lines which is connected between each vertices. And your V of G3, that is, you can, it's clearly seen that each node is representing a vertex. So it is 0, 1, 2. And your edges is your less than 0, 1 and less than 1, 0, which means this graph is continuity. But you can also represent this as 0, 1, 0, 1 and 1, 0 and 2, 1. Anyhow, since this is having a direction, it is always better to represent this as 1, 2. And you're following. Next, let's see what are the adjacent neighbors? So adjacent neighbors are nothing but two vertices are adjacent and are also called neighbors if they are the end points of an edge. So suppose I have also taken an example here, that is A and B are adjacent. So let's see what is A and B in this diagram. So it's mentioned that if they are the end points of an edge, so if you take this as an edge, you have an end point here and you also have an end point here. They're said to be adjacent if they meet the end points, that is your example, your A and B. Similar cases, this A vertex and B vertex is the end point, which means they are adjacent. Similar cases for A and C. For A and C, this edge, you can tell this edge as E1. E1 is your edge for A and C. So they are adjacent. If I have to take an example for non-adjacent, A and D. A and D do not meet and they do not have an end point. Therefore, A and D are not adjacent. The next, that is your degree, which means the number of edges incident on a node. So what do you mean by number of edges incident on a node? The number of edges which are residing or which is coming from a vertex or a node is nothing but your degree. So for example, if I take as shown in the figure, A has two lines, that means going from A to B as well as A to C, it's nothing but your edges. So degree of A is 2. Simple as that. Similarly for B, the degree of B is 2 because it has two lines, which is two lines or edges. The number of edges itself is counted as a degree. In same case for C and F, C has only 1, therefore it is 1. Even F has 1, therefore the degree of F is 1. D has no edges passing or going through, therefore the degree of D is 0. It is also called as a null graph because it is isolated. So moving to next, which is your degree of directed graph. So directed graph is nothing but which shows direction. For example, if I have two vertices and I have given a direction that is coming from A and other is going from B. So this is nothing but direction. Your direction is also called as a diagraph. Okay, so here we have when the direction is given, the number of degree, that means it be split into in degree and out degree. So in degree is nothing but the number of edges entering a node, and out degree is the number of edges leaving the node. So if you take for example 1, your in degree is your entering node, which is your in degree here is 1. Your out degree is a direction going out from 1 to 2. Therefore, your degree is 1. So in total, if you add, your degree will be 2. Similarly, in case of 2, your in degree, which pointing towards 2, is nothing but which is entering. Your in degrees, which is entering, is nothing but 2. And your out degree is 3. How? Because your self loop is also going out as well as coming in. It's considered as 2. Okay. So therefore, your out degree here will be 1, 2, and 3. Therefore, your out degree is 3. The total when you add in degree and out degree, the total degrees will be 5. Okay. So moving on to complete graph. So complete graph is nothing but a simple graph in which every pair of vertices are adjacent. So what does this mean? Which means every node or every vertices is being connected. Suppose for example, if I take this star shaped graph, you have 5 vertices. You can see none of the vertices are left behind as it has a complete line, which means every line is connected to every node. Similar cases for the other two. Every line is connected to every node. This is nothing but your complete graph. It's been completed. If you look at this diagram also, you can see every line is being completed. So if you calculate the number of vertices n, Then there are n into n minus 1 edges. How, suppose if I have taken this triangle, your n vertices are 3, which means here you have 3 vertices. So 3 into, your formula says n into n minus 1 by 2, which means 3 into 3 minus 1 by 2. 3 into 2, which means divided by 2, you get 3, which is nothing but your edges. So you do have 3 edges for your 3 vertices. Similar cases for 4. This is your complete graph. Like if the number of vertices n, then there are n into n minus 1 divided by 2 edges. So that's how you can calculate a complete graph. Even if you take 4, it is 4 into 4 minus 1 divided by 2, which is nothing but 4 into 3 by 2. So it's 2, which means it is 6. So let's calculate how 6. In 4 vertices, you have 1, 2, 3, and 4, and your diagonal elements are 6. Okay. So moving on to your connected and disconnected graphs. So what is connected graph? So connected graphs means there exists at least one path between two vertices. So when you look at your H1 has two vertices. It is being connected completely. Therefore, this is your connected graph. So what is disconnected? Otherwise, in the sense, if there is no path between any two vertices, only then it is called a disconnected. So for example, here if you take H3, here this is together called a graph because A, B, C, D, E, H3 is representing a graph. But here you can see this is disconnected completely. Therefore, this is disconnected. Even H2 is your completely connected graph. So a graph is connected if any two vertices of a graph are connected by a path. So coming to planar graph. So what is a planar graph? Planar graph is a graph that can be drawn on a plane such that there are no two edges intersect. So simple definition for a planar graph is nothing but this diagram over here. This graph or a diagram which is having intersection cannot be a planar. This can be a planar as it does not have intersection. So how can you redraw this graph to make it a planar? You can take the 4 vertices as shown. To make it diagonal, you can draw one diagonal. You cannot draw the other diagonal as it's going to intersect. So to connect this part to another, you can simply join it on the other way around. So this is nothing but your planar graph. So next is your subgraph, which we have already discussed, but the definition for subgraph is a graph whose vertices and edges are the subset of another graph. This is terminology that I wanted to discuss. As graph is nothing but you represent it as G dash, which means D dash is equal to V dash of A dash for graph GE. So that's like taking a part of your main graph and making it to a G dash graph. Here G dash is represented by G1, okay, such that V dash is a subset of V and E dash is a subset of E. So then G is a super graph of G. So if you take, for example, I have a graph here on G, taking the subset in the sense like I have taken C and D as my subset, which means this DC still belongs to graph G, but it's a subset of a weighted graph. So weighted graph is a graph for which each edge has associated weight. So it's usually given by a weight function E of R, which means your edge is having some weight or some value assigned than giving it as ABC. So here you can see that for example, two vertex has an edge E. So your E has a weightage of 1.2. This is nothing but your weighted graph. Listing out is nothing but your weighted graph. Okay.